Hey guys, I hope you enjoyed the journey from Dalton's theory up to discovery of electron. We saw that electrons have a negative charge, but we still don't know how much of negative charge did they have. To find out their charge, we need to separate the electron from the atom and then measure its charge. But that won't be an easy task. But there was one person who did this impossible task, and that was Robert Millikan. Robert Millikan had an ingenious idea to measure the charge of electron to a very precise value. And he did this using his famous oil drop experiment, for which he made an apparatus. For this experiment, he created a unique apparatus. So let's take a look at it. As you can see here, there were two metallic plates. The top plate separated the apparatus into two regions, the upper region and the lower region. Now these two plates were connected to a variable voltage source. There was also a tiny hole in the top plate through which only one droplet could pass at a given point of time. To make these oil droplets, he used an atomizer. An atomizer creates oil droplet just like how perfume spray creates the mist. In the lower region, there was a telescope to observe the movement of the droplets and a small hole for the X-rays which were coming from the X-ray source. Are you wondering what was the use of these X-rays? Well, X-rays are these high energy radiation which are so powerful that they can even ionize the gas. By ionize, I mean the gas particles get charged up. When these ionized gas particles collide with the oil droplets, the oil droplets get positively charged. Now, while the voltage source was off, the oil droplets will simply fall down because of the gravitational force which is pulling them downward. But there's nothing interesting in that. What if we could make these oil droplets to float in the air? That sounds interesting. So let's see what happens when the voltage source is turned on. When the power was turned on, the top plate gets negatively charged and the bottom plate gets positively charged. Since oil droplets are positively charged, they get attracted towards a negatively charged plate. This means that the electrical force starts pulling these droplets upward. But they were still falling down due to gravity. The electrical force was increased by increasing the potential difference between these plates. By increasing the electrical force, the fall of the droplets slowed down and eventually, oil droplets started floating in the air. When the voltage was turned off, the droplet simply fell down due to gravity. And based on the rate of the fall of these droplets, Millikan calculated the mass of the droplet. But why do you think these droplets are floating in the air in the first place? Well, when the droplets are floating in the air, at that point, the electrical force which is pulling these droplets upward and the gravitational force which is pulling these droplets downward are exactly equal to each other. The forces applying on the droplet can be simply expressed as F electrical is equal to F gravitational. Now we can rewrite this equation as Q into E is equal to M into G, where Q is the charge of the droplet, E is the strength of the electrical field, G is the acceleration due to gravity, and M is the mass of the droplet which we found out from the rate of the fall. So finally, using this equation, Millikan found out the charge of the droplet. Oof, sounds tiring, right? But Millikan did not only stop at one droplet. In fact, he did this for several droplets and found their charge and tabulated them as shown here. He noticed that the charge of the droplet was always a multiple of minimum fixed value. To see that clearly, he divided all the charges by this value. Since the total charge on the droplet was always the multiple of a fixed value, Millikan concluded that this fixed value must be equal to the magnitude of the charge of the electron itself. And since electron is negatively charged particle, the charge of the electron should be minus 1.6 into 10 power minus 19 coulombs. Surprisingly, This value was very close to the value found later by more sophisticated instruments. Now, from Millikan's experiment, we know the charge of the electron. And from Thomson's experiment, we know the charge to mass ratio of electron. So finding the mass of the electron should not be very difficult, right? To find out the mass, we simply need to divide them, and then we'll get the mass of the electron, which was 9.1 into 10 power minus 31 kgs, which was around 1800 times less than the hydrogen, which we have already established in the last video. So clearly, we can say that Millikan was the first person to devise a method to find out a property of a subatomic particle. So till now, we have learned that electrons are negatively charged subatomic particles. We even found out the charge and the mass of these particles. But don't you think there must be something to counter the charge of the electron, because atom must be neutral overall? Does that mean there are other subatomic particles? Well, to know the answer to these questions, stay tuned. So let's summarize all the things that we have learned today. By measuring the rate of the fall of the droplet, Millikan found out the mass of the droplet. The fall of these droplets could be retarded or stopped by simply varying the electrical force, which can be done by varying the potential difference between these two plates. Millikan made the droplet to float in the air by equalizing the gravitational force and the electrical force. Using this condition, he could find the charge of the droplet. Millikan found that the total charge on the droplet was always a multiple of fixed value. He concluded that this fixed value was charge of the electron, which was 1.6 into 10 power minus 19 coulombs. By dividing the charge of the electron with charge to mass ratio of electron, he found out the mass of the electron, which was 9.1 into 10 power minus 31 kgs.